Hi everyone and welcome to Bitwig Studio. In this video we'll take a closer look at the volume fade and crossfade features for audio clips. As you navigate to the margin of an audio clip, a white handle appears to indicate that you can now just click and drag it to apply a fade. Remember to make use of the adjustable track height feature here, to get a more detailed view of the clip's audio waveform and the fade. You can hold the Shift key to disable any snapping while you drag. To turn the linear fade into a curve, just click and drag the fade slope. A crossfade can be applied between two neighboring audio clips. Naturally, a crossfade only makes sense if at least one of these clips is not at its full length or is set to loop mode, so there is some hidden audio material to blend or crossfade into the second clip. The crossfade curves can again be shaped individually or simultaneously when you click and drag the point of intersection. As you navigate away from the curves, you also get the option to move the entire crossfade while keeping the clips themselves in place. When a clip is selected, the Inspector panel allows to view and edit the fade properties numerically, and to toggle the fade slopes between normal and S-shape. Another way to toggle this shape is by holding the Alt key while clicking on a fade. Holding the Control key while clicking resets the center gain value of the fade to the default 0 dB. On Mac, it's the Command key. You might also want to reset the fades of a clip entirely. In the Clip drop-down menu, you'll find the Reset Fades function, and also Auto Fade, which applies a very short fade at both clip ends to eliminate possible clicks. Both of these functions are also available in the contextual menu of a clip. Another way to apply fades is by making a time selection, and then selecting the Auto Fade function from the Time drop-down menu. As you might know, audio clips in Bitwig Studio are not just representing an audio file. In fact, audio clips are containers in which you can freely combine and edit multiple audio events. Consequently, fades and crossfades are also available at the level of audio events within the clip, where they just work in the same fashion as with Arranger clips.